Oh! Oh! Woo-hoo-hoo! Oh my god. Oh my god, we slaying, we feasting and feasting on them. Gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. So today we are going to be showcasing the No Recoil Mac 10 here in Black Ops Cold War. Now, the brand new DLC weapon has been getting a lot of talk here in Warzone, but in Cold War, people have not really been using it too much here because that has a lot of recoil and the gun, just you might not be able to win a lot of gunfights here with it. But in today's video, we are going to show you guys how you can put No Recoil here on your Mac 10 and you can laser everybody in close range gunfights, medium range gunfights, and even long range gunfights where it maybe struggles a little bit. This class setup definitely should be able to help you guys out just a little bit. But before we get into the video, I do want to ask each and every single one of you guys, do me a really big favor, smack an early like on today's video and subscribe to the channel if you are brand new. We are on that road to 26,000 subscribers. We are less than 100 subscribers away. Hopefully we can hit that fairly soon. You will not regret it. There's a lot of great videos coming very, very soon. But without further ado, let's get into the class setup here now with the Mac 10. This thing is a freaking laser. Just look at it right now. Like, this is the smallest gun in the game, and the attachments that we're throwing on this thing just makes this thing like ginormous, and it really plays super, super deadly. But anyway, moving on, we are going to start off with the gunfighter wild card here. If you guys are not running the gunfighter wild card here on the Mac 10, you are really making a big mistake here, because like I said earlier, with some of the base attachments on this gun, there's just so much recoil. It's really hard to control. So throwing on all 8 attachments for this gun is going to make a world of a difference for you, and you're really going to notice how less of recoil this gun really is going to have now. But moving on to the attachments here, we're going to start off with the Microflex LED. I am not a fan whatsoever of the iron sight on this gun. For whatever reason, I just find it so super difficult to just see my enemies and also even be able to win gunfights here with that recoil pattern that this gun will have as well. Moving on to the muzzle, we do have the SOCOM Eliminator. This is going to give us an 85% increase to the muzzle flash concealment and a 17% increase to your vertical recoil control. There is a slight decrease to the horizontal recoil control, but we will go ahead and fix that here later on to try to even that out a little bit. Moving on to the barrel on this thing, we do have the 6.5 rifled. This is going to give you a 25% increase to your effective damage range. Now, this is a really big one because you need to increase that damage range as much as possible. This gun is deadly up close, but it's really struggling and lacking in those long-range gunfights. So adding on that 25% increase to the damage range, it actually does make a really big difference, and I've noticed a lot more gunfights that I've been winning in those longer encounters as well. We do have the SWAT laser sight here. This is going to give you a 30% increase to your hip fire accuracy. This gun is, like I said, it shoots so fast, so being able to hip fire on this thing when you're pushing up here, because you're going to be playing super aggressive with this, you're going to get into that enemy base as fast as possible. So there's a lot of times where it's a lot easier just to hip fire than to actually aim down your sight, so adding that laser sight in is going to definitely make things so much easier for you. We do have the field agent grip here. This is, in my opinion, is the most important attachment. Like, even if you guys don't want to run 5 attachments for whatever reason, you need to at least make sure you have this attachment on. This gives you a 6% increase to your vertical recoil control and a 20% increase to that horizontal recoil control. Now, there is just so much recoil on this gun. This at least helps it out a little bit to be able to control that, so you at least are able to control your aim a little bit, and it makes a world of a difference in your longer range gunfights where you're not going to see nearly as much recoil. It's going to look like you have zero recoil at all on this gun when you do have this attachment on. Moving on to the magazine, I do have the 53 round drum magazine here. I do not have the speed one unlocked just yet, but as soon as I unlock that, I'll switch it out for there just so I can reload a little faster as well. The drop shot wrap is what I'm rocking here. I just don't have the airborne elastic wrap yet. If you guys have been watching some of the class setups that we've been talking about in past videos, I die by this attachment. This is my favorite attachment in this game. Just don't have it unlocked just yet, so until then, we're gonna rock that drop shot wrap. And last but not least, we are rocking the wire stock here. This is gonna give you a 10% sprint to fire rate time. You're already super fast with this gun. Adding that on is just going to make it so much easier to get into that enemy base as fast as possible, because you're going to want to have all your gunfights for the most part as close range encounters. So just having that increase increase is definitely going to help it out. And this one doesn't have any cons. That's why I've been rocking that over some of the other ones. I think there's some attachments that give you an increased sprint to fire time, but it does like decrease your hip fire or some other things. I just don't like that. So having the pro, no cons here, makes a world of a difference. And that's going to be the attachments here that you are going to rock here for your MAC 10. Let's get into some gameplay now. Let's try this thing out. I promise you, try out this class setup and you're going to win so many more gunfights, and you're really going to enjoy the way that you this gun does play. Without further ado, let's get into the gameplay. All right, so let's give this MAC 10 a try. First things first, the rate of fire on this thing is absolutely insane. So I gotta try my best just to get close range gunfights as much as possible here, because anything long distance is gonna be really a coin flip and if I'm gonna win this or not, just with how fast this fire rate is. You can try your best to make this have as little to no recoil as possible, but I mean, at the end of the day, when a gun shoots this quick, it's pretty much impossible. This is definitely one of those guns that you really gotta rush with. If you're not rushing and you're kind of like sitting back, it's not gonna play to your playstyle at all. So I gotta try to get up into the enemy's face as much as possible here. Oh, dude right here. Let's see if I can see this guy pull out a pistol here. No shot he's gonna win that gunfight against me. Oh, there's a dude right here. Got you. I think there's another one. There is. Let me reload real quick. Got you. Ooh, that was kind of shaky there. Let's call this biplane and see where they're coming from. I guess the best comparison I can have with this gun, I mean, this is kind of a weird comparison, but if you guys played Modern Warfare 3 and used like the Scorpion, which I believe it was a secondary at the time, that's kind of what this gun reminds me of, because it's one of those guns that's super good up close, but once you get to long range gunfights, that's where it gets. What? Hello? What? What was my man what was he doing? My man just used his parachute to push in. Wait, where did he go? There we go. Oh my God, slayed this guy out. I forget that you can use your parachutes on this map, but I think my man thought he was playing Ground War. Like I was saying before though, like the Scorpion, like this gun is one of those guns that like you might want to throw on a like overkill with this class setup as well. Like if you don't want to run 8 attachments, and it might actually really benefit you. Or just pick up like an assault rifle off the ground, and once like you find a teammate that died, like right here, like I could probably go pick up this teammate's body or a gun or something like that. Like this. Here, let me try this real quick. Let me do this. Got that guy. Now let me push up, see if this is gonna work out. Like this might be the best way to go with this gun. Tell me that there's nobody here now and they flipped. I'm gonna try something right here. I'm gonna see if I can try to get pushed up, flank these guys by making this as a move. Hold on, let's see. Let's see if this is gonna work. Got one. I hear him shooting. Hello, what are you doing? All right, yeah, that flank route really does work. So if you guys have not used that on this map yet, if you guys are only using like SMGs, try that route out. Let me know if it works out for you. Oh man. Oh God, go up. I don't know what in the world this guy is doing, but I'm not complaining. I'll take the kill. All right, one thing that I really am liking about the fact that this game is free to play for the next week, we have a lot of low levels, a lot of people on the trial at the moment, so skill-based matchmaking isn't nearly going to be as strong. This is kind of like our version of the Christmas noobs right now, so I'm not going to complain. We have 4 of them in the lobby at the moment. Let's see how we can do. All right, this really is probably the best case scenario at the moment. We got a pretty small map, so most of our engagements are going to be close quarters. Oh, oh my God, you need to delete your game. If you're part of that free trial, man, I don't suggest you buying the game. Actually, buy it so I can play against you more often. Close range encounters. This is exactly what we're looking here with this gun. Hello, how you doing? More people over this way. Hopefully it should be pretty easy. Got you. Oh God. I'm not gonna lie though, I'm actually having a lot of fun using this gun. It kind of changes the pace for me a little bit. Oh God, I did not mean to slide. I meant to go prone there. Kind of changes the pace a little bit, because especially with the way skill-based matchmaking has been, you really gotta where's he at? You really gotta play pretty weird, which isn't like my play style, just to be able to compete with skill-based matchmaking. So I kind of like, oh God, they're all over here. I kind of like this, just being able to run and gun, play super aggressive. Got you. Oh my God, thank God for drop shotting, let's be honest. But definitely, guys, let me know if you guys have stayed to this point into the video. Let me know in the comments, what's your favorite SMG so far to use here in Black Ops Cold War? I've been really enjoying using this MAC 10. I know there's a guy right above me. Hopefully, he doesn't see me. I can push up. Maybe he turns around now. Nope. I've been really enjoying this MAC 10 recently. I know the AK-74U is definitely, by far, super powerful compared to some of the other guns. The Bullfrog is still really good. Yeah, let me know. What's your favorite SMG? Oh my god, the hipfire on this is disgusting. Got you as well. There should be another one right here. 3, 2, 1. Oh, I gotta reload. I got 16 bullets. That's not good. I will say, although, like, we've done the best thing possible to try to, like, reduce the recoil on this gun, it's still there. Like, close-range gunfights is not terrible. I can really control it. Like, here, like, that's pretty easy. But once we get into those longer-range gunfights, that's where it really starts to get into effect, and it's very, very difficult to compete against. So if you that's why you're... Woohoo! Just kidding. Maybe if you just burst fire. I lied. Burst fire, and you're good to go. God dang. All right, teammate, you should be able to get that kill. Thank you. Oh my god. They got a gunship now. How are they getting all these streaks? I feel like I'm going off again. They gotta be care packages that they're getting these streaks from. Cause I feel like I'm going off this game. I got nearly 30 kills in a TDM right now, and somehow they got a gunship, attack helicopter, and I haven't even gotten my harp yet. All right, last kill for the win. MAC-10. Here in Black Ops Cold War, it's decent. It's really good in close range gunfights, but it's decent at best in long range if you are bursting the weapon, burst firing, I should say. No recoil in close range gunfights. It gets a little hectic when it gets to longer range. Let me know what you guys think of this gun. Definitely let me know your thoughts about this weapon in the comments down below. Thank you all so much for watching today's video. If you guys have not already, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel if you are brand new. And I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a great rest of your day and peace out.